Cuentos del Abuelito. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. On this occasion, I'll be narrating something a little different. A love and sad story, the Titanic, the Jack and Rose version. If you like this type of story, leave a like, a comment, and even share the video, you know, for support and all that type of thing. And with all that being said, let's get to it. Rose was a beautiful, wealthy first class passenger aboard the Titanic. She boarded the ship with her snooty mother and her cruel fiancé, Kel. Jack was a third class passenger and a penniless, though talented artist. He won his tickets in a game of poker and he boarded the ship with his best friend Fabrizio. He was also very optimistic and very excited to board the Titanic. 2 days after Rose boarded the Titanic, she attempted to commit suicide by throwing herself off the ship to avoid her arranged marriage to Kel. She was dissuaded by third-class passenger Jack, who warned her how cold the water was and that if she jumped, he would have to jump in after her. When Jack tried to help her back over the railing, she slipped and fell, hanging dangerously over the edge. With Jack gripping her hand, Jack managed to pull her back over the railing. Hearing her screams, some nearby crew members ran and found him sprawled out on the floor. Due to Rose's screams and the fact that Jack had removed his jacket and shoes, it appeared as if he was trying to take advantage of her. Quartermaster Rowe sent for the master at arms, who also brought Rose's fiance Kel, who attempted to have Jack arrested. However, Rose informed him that she had slipped and Jack had risked his own life to save her, although she lied by saying that she had been looking over the railing to see the propellers. Jack did not contradict her, meaning that they now shared a secret. Kel attempted to bring Rose inside, forgetting all about Jack, until Archibald suggested that Jack be rewarded somehow. Kel instructed his valet, Lovejoy, to give Jack $20, but Rose protested that her life was worth more than that. Kel then invited Jack to eat with him in the first class dining area the following evening, apparently as an expression of gratitude, though really believing it would be an opportunity to show him up. The following day, Rose sought out Jack to thank him. However, she began to feel uncomfortable when Jack started to question her motive for wanting to jump if she really did love Kel. Offended by his audacity, she was getting ready to leave. Rose then rethought this, and realizing they were on the first class deck, she then ordered Jack to leave. Jack laughed at her hypocrisy, and she scornfully took his notebook. However, she was impressed upon seeing his drawings in it. She told him that he had a talent. He sees people. They spent the entire day talking about their lives. That afternoon, Jack taught Rose how to spit off the side of the ship. When her mother caught them doing this, she was appalled and took Rose back to her room to prepare for dinner. Another first class passenger, Molly, assisted Jack in dressing for dinner with the first class passengers by lending him a tuxedo intended for her son. At dinner, Rose explained to Jack who all of the first class passengers were and showed him around before dining. He charmed the entire table with his humor and insightful comment about how life is a gift and he didn't intend on wasting it. As he was leaving, he slipped a note into Rose's hand reading, "Make it count. Meet me at the clock," meaning the honor and glory clock at the top of the grand staircase. Hesitantly, she went to the clock where Jack asked her if she wanted to go to a real party. He took her down below decks where the third class were partying. But while she and Jack were dancing, Kel's manservant Lovejoy spied on them. As Jack and Rose were walking back from the third class party, Jack talked heard the song Come Josephine in my flying machine. When they saw a shooting star, Jack asked Rose what she would wish for. And she responded, something I can't have, and ran into the first class entrance. The following day, Ruth and Cal forbade Rose from ever seeing Jack again. The next morning, Rose and Cal were having breakfast on their private veranda. Cal had been informed by Lovejoy about Rose and Jack's evening after dinner. Rose said that she was not a worker of his, but his fiance. This resulted in Cal flipping the table and leaving in a huff. Rose tried to help her maid clean up the mess, but she refused. Not long after, Rose was getting ready to attend the Titanic service when her mother comes in. She aggressively tightens Rose's corset and informs her about their debt and situation and how she must marry Cal. This aggravates Rose. Then Jack went up to the first class church service to speak to Rose. He was denied entry and Lovejoy tried to pay him off, but he refused, saying he just wanted to speak with Rose. He was taken back to his quarters. On the same day the ship hit the iceberg, Jack disguised himself as a first class passenger by donning a stolen jacket. He intercepted Rose as she was being given a tour of the ship by Thomas. He took her to the gym, which was empty, as it was a Sunday afternoon, affording them some privacy. He told her that she clearly had an adventurous spirit and was yearning to breathe free, but was trapped by her mother and Cal. Marrying Cal would doom her to a life of misery. Although poor, he offered to save her from this fate. Rose, in denial, claimed she loved Cal and asked Jack to leave her alone. Later, Rose observed a first-class mother and her child, correcting the child's posture. Then she went back to find Jack to tell him that she had changed her mind. They shared their first kiss on the bow at sunset, the last light of day the Titanic would ever see. They went back to Rose's room, where Rose asked Jack to draw her wearing nothing but the Heart of the Ocean necklace that Cal had given her as an engagement present. Afterwards, they locked the drawing in Cal's safe. They realized that Lovejoy was coming to check on Rose and ran down the hallway in an effort to escape from him. The two ended up running through the boiler room into the hold. They wandered into the cargo hold and into the backseat of a car, where they passionately made love for the first and sadly only time. When they returned to the boat deck, Rose told Jack when the ship docked, she'd run off with him and they passionately kissed. However, they broke apart upon feeling the ship shudder and saw some ice from an iceberg crumble into the deck. They then found out that the ship had hit an iceberg and the situation was serious. Rose and Jack went to tell Cal and Rose's mother. However, when they got there, Cal and Lovejoy had staged a robbery and managed to sneak the Heart of the Ocean necklace into Jack's pocket after seeing the drawing and framed him for stealing it. Jack was arrested and sent down with the master at arms. He was chained to a pipe and left for dead. Rose went back and freed him by using an axe to chop the handcuffs apart. Afterwards, Cal and Jack convinced Rose to get into one of the lifeboats for the ship to escape because the ship was sinking. Rose got into it but jumped out as it was leaving and got back on the ship because she refused to leave Jack behind. Cal, enraged by this, chased the two with a gun into the ship in unsuccessful attempt to kill them. The two ran through the rapidly flooding ship, trying to escape the water which was rising up to their necks. When they reached the upper deck again, the ship split in two. They climbed to the back of the ship and they rose vertically in the air. So they climbed over the railing where Rose had attempted suicide a couple nights earlier. Both escaped the shipwreck alive and ended up in the water. Rose climbed onto a door from the wreck, but it was not buoyant enough to support Jack as well. Jack. So he had to stay in the freezing water. He made Rose promise that no matter what happened to him, that she would do everything she wanted to do with her life and die an old woman warm in her bed, rather than die here with her whole life ahead of her. Jack died of hypothermia that night. However, Rose was rescued. She took Jack's last name and did fulfill her promise to Jack. Rose married and had children and managed to pursue an acting career, just as she and Jack had talked about on the doomed ship. The two were reunited in heaven when she walks into the grand staircase area where all the victims of the Titanic are waiting for her. Young Rose is in a white dress and walks up to Jack, who is standing at the clock. The two kiss passionately, reunited after an 84-year separation.